Hi, this is Mike Negami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. Today, I would like to talk about how to make a Gantt chart using an Excel template. In Lean Sigma project, we often use this tool at the end of the define phase. This is an example of a completed Gantt chart. From the left, there are the task name, task lead, task date, start date, end date, and progress percentage columns. The right side of the form has a horizontal bar chart that represents each task's work period visually. This tool better enables us to make our project plan more efficient and practical during its composition. In my opinion, this process is more valuable than the product of the process. For example, since it's easy to compare the length of the bars visually, you can decide on more realistic task periods. Another reason is since it makes you consider the front-to-back relationship among the tasks, you can make an efficient and short project plan. Now let's practice making a Gantt chart. But first, we have to make a WBS work breakdown structure. You can list up all the Gantt chart project tasks after making the WBS. I explained how to make a WBS in the previous videos. Please watch those too. You can download both the WBS and Gantt chart Excel templates from my blog site, econoshift.com. This is a completed WBS from a previous video. Here is a section of deliverables and tasks. We are going to copy and paste the WBS deliverables and tasks to the Gantt chart. Since my WBS uses merged cells, you can't copy and paste merged cells. If you do, this will happen. Therefore, copy only the text in your formula bar, paste it onto the Gantt chart. Let's do one more. In order to distinguish between deliverables and tasks at the tasks cell, click here, increase indent. Then the text will move to the right, little by little. Repeat this. Then here is completed entry of all tasks and task leads. Next, enter your project's start and end dates here. Then these dates will appear on the chart header automatically. Enter each task's work days and start date in the next cells. Then each task's end date and the dates needed bar will appear. Repeat this on all tasks, then it will look like this. There is one very important thing here. When you enter each task's start date, please do that while considering the preceding necessary processes that are required by each task. For example, this task's preceding necessary process is the above task. Therefore, one day after the above task's end date became this task's start date. How about this one? Its necessary task is way before this one. So one day after this end date became the task's start date. By doing this, you can plan your project's length short naturally. Now click this upside down triangle icon in column E and sort by auto filter. It will sort by task lead. You can check if your task allocation is even and practical. If not, reallocate them. After checking all, bring the order back by sort A to Z in column B. This is a completed Gantt chart. Today, I talked about how to make a Gantt chart. It's a necessary tool in project management. Furthermore, I use this for personal events as well, like vacation trips or moving preparation. They are very useful. With this template, you can make your own Gantt chart very easily in a very short amount of time. Therefore, try to utilize a Gantt chart in your work or for your personal events. Thank you very much for viewing. If you like my videos, please click the subscribe button. Thanks.